is a coordinated activity happening across this nation. And so we are in a state of emergency. Black people are dying in a state of emergency. We cannot look at this as an isolated incident. The reason why buildings are burning are not just for our brother George Floyd. They're burning down because people here in Minnesota are saying to people in New York, to people in California, to people in Memphis, to people all across this nation, enough is enough.
Hi, my name is Marilyn Mays, and I'm a recreation supervisor for the city of Duarte. As I'm sure you are aware, February is Black History Month. It is a time when we go back and reflect on monumental achievements, Black heroes, inventors, and even some of our struggles. Typically, we go back in history, but this year, we don't have to go back that far because 2020 brought about one of the most memorable Black history moments in time, the Black Lives Matter movement. It was a time in our country where people of all different ethnicities, backgrounds, ages, came together to stand with African Americans in our country to say enough is enough, that Black lives matter. We have gathered perspectives from people from all over the country to talk about the impact that the Black Lives Matter had on them. It will forever go down in Black history.
Hi, Marilyn. I want to thank you for inviting me to participate in this celebration of Black History Month. And you've asked me to talk about what the Black Lives Matter movement has meant to me and maybe a little bit about what it's meant to our country. I think the Black Lives Matter movement right now as it stands is at the very, very center of reminding this country what its ideals are and how we have yet to live up to them. Now, what ideals do I mean? I think the best statement of those ideals is when you go all the way back to our Declaration of Independence. What does it say? It says, we hold these truths to be self-evident, that all persons are created equal, that they are endowed with certain inalienable rights. Among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Now, I don't have to say how many groups, whether it's Black folks, women, so many others, who have not been able to participate fully in the ideals that this country wishes to think of itself as having and promising to everybody. What Black Lives Matter has done since its founding in 2013 and so much this year is remind us how a certain group, Black folks, but many, many others, still have so far to go to get what they have been promised by this country, by the very ideals that we have been founded upon. So I want to thank the Black Lives Matter movement for everything it has done, for the vital, critical work of putting a mirror up to this country and saying, we want to be fully a part of what we have been promised. Thank you so much for letting me participate and enjoy the celebration.
Good afternoon, Mr. Bell.
How are you, sir?
I'm good. So as we honor Black History Month, I recall this past June, you and I, we participated in a Black Lives Matter march where we marched down Huntington Drive. Great event, really, really touched me in a number of different ways. It's a very moving experience. And so I'm glad to have the opportunity to talk with you today and have this conversation. As one of our pillars in this community, longtime board member, law enforcement officer, loving parent, grandparent, in your lived experience, what has the BLM movement meant to you?
What it has meant to me, again, going back to the long time as a law enforcement officer, grew up in the housing projects in Los Angeles and have an opportunity to raise 5 children here in the school district and to see a community come together for something that was this touching and to feel like that there's going to be progress right here at home meant a lot to me. So as a board member, I'm really thrilled to see that there's going to be some things we can move together and try to infuse that feeling to go throughout our community and make Black Lives Matter matter, but to make sure that all lives really matter.
So, you know, I was thinking about my own experience and kind of my own evolution with respect to the Black Lives Matter movement. And I remember being particularly outraged in late May of 2020, watching the murder of George Floyd. And it was a flashpoint moment for me, because in that time, you know, my children asked me some questions that I wasn't quite prepared for. They asked me a question on that day where they said, "Dad, what did he do?" And it was really hard for me to explain to my 12-year-old son and my 11-year-old daughter how somebody's life could be taken away over a $20 bill. And so it made me think that there was more work to be done to really bring us together and have conversations that are really, really important to move the social justice agenda forward. And so I was really appreciative of the board's support to pass a unanimous resolution denouncing racism and systemic inequalities and discrimination. And so I know we're moving in the right direction, but I really was thinking, like, what new things, what additional things do we need to really think about with respect to Black Lives Matter and social justice? What do we need to continue to focus on as an organization?
Again, you brought a point that moment with Mr. Floyd was probably one of the toughest moments I've ever experienced in my life. Being a 36-year law enforcement officer, along with being a community member and a school board member, if you get to the place where a human life is not worth that, to sit there or stand there or to kneel there and to see a life expire is frightening. And it's something that just paralyzed me to think, if we continue to live like that or to continue to raise our children like that, what kind of community we would have? So I'm, along with you and other board members, I'm looking forward to, we make sure from teachers, every administrator and school board member or members of our school district, we gotta make lives, all lives matter. And the Black Lives Movement, the Black Lives Matter movement would be a focal point for us to begin to all of it to come together for us.
Absolutely, and just my ongoing commitment, because as I kind of wrap up this conversation, our ongoing commitment has to be as superintendent, as a dad, as a community member, to continue to keep these conversations moving forward, continue to put in front of our students and in front of our scholars critical conversations, critical dialogue to continue to move our social justice initiatives forward, because all of our kids need to live in a more just society, live in a more just community. I'm committed to that, I know you are as well, and so I appreciate you, Mr. Bell. I appreciate the city of Duarte for encouraging our communities to have these critical dialogues, and just want to continue to celebrate Black History Month. Thank you so much for your time today.
My pleasure, and it's always a pleasure to serve with someone with you with the mindset you have. Thank you very much, Dr. Davis.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir.
Hey, Marilyn, super fun to participate on this with you. I think back on 2020 and COVID-19, and weirdly, I feel like I will always be grateful for it. And I will always be grateful because it caused our country to slow down and pay attention to what was happening around them. And I think people were paying attention when George Floyd was murdered. And you have seen the momentum in the Black Lives Matter movement, which for me in my career might be the single most powerful moment in history where people like me and every leader around me has said, wait a minute, this is not the kind of team I want to lead. This is not the city I want to lead. This is not the country that we want to lead, and we can do better. And for the first time in my career, it feels authentic and it feels purpose-driven, and I can genuinely say we are not going back. Thanks for asking. I am really proud to be leading a city during this time.
When I think about Black Lives Matter, I think about our fight against police brutality. I think about our fight against the educational system that keeps suspending our African-American students at an alarming rate than any other race. I think about how African-Americans are being sentenced into prisons for longer term than any other race. I think about how our women are being killed on the birthing table when they're giving birth to African-American children. And so we have a long fight to go. It's not just about the police brutality, but we're fighting against so much more so that our people can live in the 21st century without worrying about looking behind their back or anything else. So we must continue this movement.
Black Lives Matter was a call to action, a fight for social justice and equality, a battle that we have struggled with for decades in this country. It also stands as a signal that we will not be silenced or stopped until equality is shared with all of us, as it should be.
What Black Lives Matter has meant to me, specifically over the last year, the amount of awareness that they have brought to issues surrounding police brutality, the killing of unarmed Black men, the issues of social injustice towards people of color, specifically Black people. They've brought just a level of awareness that was not there before, in my opinion. I'm particularly proud of their response and the organization, the organizing of the protests and the sit-ins surrounding the killing of Mr. Floyd. And for me, as a Black man in America, to see a movement that's a grassroots movement that has a tagline that is the essence of what we've been trying to say for hundreds of years is just amazing.
Black Lives Matter means hope to me, because in 2020, when we all needed it the most, Black Lives Matter brought people of all races together. Because although we're all created equal, we don't end up equal. And as a fellow human, you must act with hope and compassion, especially if you have been blessed to suffer less injustice in the world. Seeing everyone come together gave me hope. It also reminded me to do what I can to pay it forward, because no one should suffer, especially not because of the color of their skin.
What does Black Lives Matter mean to me? Black Lives Matter to me is the unity of people that are willing to fight for justice for the Black and minority communities and want equality across races and self-identities for everyone in this nation as well as beyond and in the world.
Black Lives Matter is a fulfillment of a promise for someone who is a combat veteran and Christian like myself. In both of those roles, we're asked to stand up for those and defend those who cannot defend themselves, to speak up for those who cannot speak up for themselves, and to fight the injustices of the world. Quite often, Jesus put himself between those who were marginalized in society and those who would hurt those people. And for me, Black Lives Matter is fulfilling both the promise of our nation to create a more just nation and the promise as a Christian of bringing justice to everyone, social justice to everyone.
What does Black Lives Matter mean to me? It means giving Black communities and all minorities a voice to stand up against racism and fight for human rights.
Martin Luther King once quoted, "Our lives begin to end the day we become silent about the things that matter." I support Black Lives Matter. I am Louis Valenzuela. God bless.
The Black Lives Matter movement to me has felt like a giant awakening. 2020 gave us so many challenges, and it really forced us to open our eyes and see just how connected we all truly are, and that we can learn from our past, and that together we can grow and we can be better.
Meant unity for once. Here in Texas, I live in a predominantly white city, a suburb, and yet we saw people of all colors, especially white people, coming together to express their disenchantment with how people of color, especially Black people, have been treated, especially during this presidency. So for me, Black Lives Matter was huge, and it changed my neighborhood, and I think it was the loudest thing spoken during 2020 for sure. I think it had an impact on the next generation for sure.
To me, the Black Lives Matter movement symbolizes the power of the masses. This past year has been extremely difficult, but being a part of peaceful protests in Detroit and Chicago made me realize that love truly does trump hate. The impact of the movement will continue to make waves and change our society on a daily basis for years to come. Working with high school students in Chicago right now, I see how strong and passionate the younger generation is, and I look forward to the things that will change in the coming years.
Hello, my name is Lucas Smith. Black Lives Matter has played a very significant role, not only for me, but for the people around me and for the people of America. And honestly, I genuinely think for the people of the entire planet. This summer, Black Lives Matter shined a light on a part of America that is really hard to see, and that a lot of people in our country sadly haven't seen or are trying to ignore. If it weren't for Black Lives Matter and all the peaceful protests that they put on, I genuinely think there would be a lot more racists in this country, and a lot of people rethought some of the mindsets that they had once they saw the peaceful protests and saw what people were trying to preach, because they didn't really know how people of color were being treated in this country. But it's good that everybody knows now. So I thank Black Lives Matter for shining a light on that, and I hope they keep going strong.
Hi, I'm Sandy, and I live in Eugene, Oregon. The BLM movement means to me dialogue and hope. This picture sits on my wall, and it's from 1999. It's my sons and I on the MLK March Day. We had 30 to 40 people show up that day. We felt pretty good about that. But in 2020, hundreds, if not thousands of people showed up to march 120 days straight just in Eugene, Oregon alone. I've had conversations with my mother, my brother, my best friends, my husband who is a captain at the police department, my kids. And I believe that all these dialogues are going to create change. I have hope for our future. And really, I am so proud of youth for standing up and saying no more. I hope for our future.
Hi, my name is Eric Klinko, and I'm a captain with the Eugene Police Department. The Black Lives Matter movement to me has meant a lot of different things. First of all, I see it as the most important social justice movement any time in the last 50 years since the 1960s. The murder of George Floyd in May of last year set off a tumultuous summer of protests of people of all races, colors, and creeds, letting out their frustration and anger with the inequities in our society, and primarily against the inequities within the criminal justice system, police, courts, prisons. People of all races came together for a single vision. It was successful in many ways, but the work remains to be done. 2021 is about really enacting the reforms that will bring equity for all people within our criminal justice system. Thank you.
I'm Chief Elvia Williams of the Riston Park Police Department. Black Lives Matter made a big difference in how police departments across our nation enforce the law. It has required officers to be accountable for the misuse and abuse of their powers. So Black Lives Matter has forced police departments to look at their policies and their procedures to ensure that we're not violating anyone's constitutional rights.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. 2020 was a significant year for all of us. Of course, we're still fighting the coronavirus, but also we went through Black Lives Matter. Black Lives Matter really shows us the disparity that we still have here in America about equality. We need to embrace equality. No matter what race you are, we should all work together, embrace each other, help each other out, and making sure that everyone is equal here in America in the near future. Thank you.
Black Lives Matter. The movement to me is very important. It started with Colin Kaepernick when he took that knee. The way that the league treated him, I knew right then that there was something that needed to be done. We as a people have brought a lot of nationalities together with this movement. It's very important, and it's just important to stand together and know that we can't continue to have the injustice of our people. Black Lives Matter is something I will continue to support and be behind. Thank you.
Hello from Washington, D.C. What Black Lives Matter means to me is just a wake-up call for police to stop killing unarmed and nonviolent Black and brown people. It's a beautiful movement. I got to see it up close and personal in Washington, D.C. Hundreds of people marching for months, people of all different colors and creeds. And now the movement needs to transition into action. We need legislation for police reform. We need better services for our communities. And I just look forward to this year and what action we're actually going to take for this movement. Thank you.
BLM symbolized the true soul of America's different races, religions, genders, ages, and social backgrounds, all supporting and embracing the promise of justice and equality for all. And in stark contrast, MAGA brought out the worst in Americans. But on November 3rd, 2020, America rejected the movement of hate and exclusion and one multicultural voice through their vote.
The Black Lives Matter movement is a blueprint for how the future generation is going to be treated and just, you know, how we're going to be respected. And it all starts with the movement.
What Black Lives Matter has meant to me in the past year as number one, just the feeling that we're not done. It's been quite a year for awareness and hope, frustration, but also a lot of love and understanding that came from around the world. And it was really nice to see. I have two small kids and they deserve so much better than what we've allowed, just like every Black child deserves better. And I am hopeful that we're going to continue and we're going to keep pushing for even more progress.
Hi, I'm Luna. This is my wife, Christy, and our son, Landon. We were happy to speak about the Black Lives Movement and what that meant for us this summer. For me, particularly, it was a real opportunity to teach my son about what equality for all means. We know as a non-traditional family, unfortunately, firsthand, what it feels like not to be recognized for who you are and valued. I wanted Landon to know that some things are worth standing up and fighting for. And for us, that's what the Black Lives Matter movement meant. Black Lives Do Matter.
Hi, my name is Denise Barreto, and I'm the inaugural director of equity and inclusion for the second largest county in the country, Cook County, Illinois. If I had to sum up what Black Lives Matter movement meant to me in 2020, the word is catalytic, right? They've always been around. They've always had solid demands and lots of opportunities, but it was in 2020 that they sparked a global discussion on anti-Blackness and the scourge of racism that doesn't just exist in our country, but all over the world.
The impact that Black Lives Matter had on me was the fact that I was proud that we were able to collectively come together to combat racial inequalities in this country, but at the same time disappointed that we are still at a place where we have to fight and march for equal rights and equality.
In 2020, Black Lives Matter continued to fight to bring awareness to the injustices that Blacks face at the hands of law enforcement. Last year, they continued this fight by continuing to bring fundamental awareness and responsibility to the community.
The Black Lives Matter movement gave a voice to the voices who was and still tired of the racial injustice going on in this country and around the world. The Black Lives Matter movement was a movement of young Black and brown, young Asian and white people in this country that demand change and won't stop fighting till change comes. The Black Lives Matter movement was just not a moment in history last summer, but a movement to get more minorities out to vote, to get them politically involved, and to put pressure on elected officials today that they can't and won't be silenced, ignored, and unseen. The Black Lives Matter movement is about advocating and organizing for what's right and for what's just. And the Black Lives Matter movement is here today, and they will be here tomorrow.